to be here.
So, like, I'm going to try something with you because I just know you'll get this. So, you know when you smell somebody barbecuing or fresh cut grass, it brings back memories like this.
Yeah.
I'm going to test you on something. I'm going to play something. I'm going to see what memory comes to mind. Listen to this.
Okay.
What emotions? What comes back?
You mean aside from all the colors my face is turning right now? Thank you for that. I think I'm matching these poinsettias here. So, guys, if you don't know this, this is Alvin and the Chipmunks playing.
Oh, yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Alvin and the Chipmunks. Not just the average version. This is their holiday version. And my father would play this for us every single year that we would decorate the tree. Now it's super cute. Oh my God, there we go. Yes.
Aww.
Now we were up super early, so teenage version of me was not very excited about that.
You were not
quite getting it.
Yeah.
But we would do this as children. Now children grow into teenagers, grow into adults. Now my father still does this tradition as in our late 20s.
Late 20s.
You know, we'll be there decorating the tree to Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Oh,
like,
I love
and none
that.
Of us have the heart to say, like, Dad, maybe we should kind of upgrade the music. So.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so you just
is
took me back.
Is it still on vinyl? Is it still?
It's like, rip. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Something got scratched. That's, well, speaking of tradition, your character in Sharing Christmas runs a shop.
Yes.
That runs into a little bit of a pickle.
Yes, a little bit of a pickle, a jar of pickles, if you will.
Yeah, what exactly?
So Stephanie Nicholas, my character's name, and she begins as a manager of her family's shop and eventually runs the entire store. And this store has been open for 40 years. And of course, the first day of running the shop, they get an eviction notice.
Oh boy.
Things are not going well. That's the pickle right there. Things are not going well.
Brick and mortar's going down.
It's going down. And of course, it's a big real estate tycoon that's looking to decimate our facility, taking it all over and building luxury.
They do.
And this happens all the time.
All the time.
It does happen.
This happens all the time. Mm-hmm. So Stephanie, of course, is not too happy about the situation. And after she's closing her shop for the night, a handsome gentleman, Kohler, walks into the shop, Bobby Campo, is the character, Michael, and he just so happens to have knowledge in real estate. Just so yes.
That's a little odd.
A little odd, right?
Yeah.
Yes. So I take his word for it, and he starts giving me advice. And then as time goes on, I realize that it is indeed his company that is shutting us down.
No.
So the eternal optimist that Stephanie is, she keeps coming up with different tactics to keep her store alive. So whether that she sees that through to fruition or not, you're going to have to tune in.
Oh. Well, I will tell. I don't know if it's a tactic what she is doing with this lovely real estate developer that has come into her shop of making him fall in love with her or not.
Oh, yes.
But I think it's gonna work in her favor.
She's working it. She has the doe eyes down to it. Science. And the eternal optimism.
And she has them, I think, wrapped around her little finger. Let's take a look at the sparks fly.
All do your customers have a collection like Mr. Cranston?
Quite a few. Why?
I was just thinking, where are they gonna go if you're shop closes down.
Well, tell that to Helen McLean.
You know what? I think I will.
Wait, really?
Yeah. I'm not gonna let her close the shop. We should,
Definitely.
Yeah, I think, I'm seeing you tomorrow.
I'll see you tomorrow too.
Yeah. Have a good night.
The snow falling, and of course there is just like a symphony behind us playing that music. Yeah. He couldn't help but fall
you
in love with it.
You could just everybody do one.
Yes, they're just playing right there.
Let me go back to that picture of your dad. Your dad's a tall guy, right?
Like, yes, he's 6'4".
He's 6'4". Wow.
Big guy.
So, therefore, the man that was going to one day be your husband had to at least be 6'4".
Oh, he had to.
Yeah.
So he can reach stuff in the
cabin. Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, you grow accustomed to these things growing up.
So, no, your husband, Stephen, is 6'4" tall.
He's a big guy.
He's a
And he's from Australia, so it's just something in the water. I think they just make them.
Well, but you had a really, I won't say a crazy meeting, but it was crazy.
Like kind
the way
of.
You guys
it
met.
Swords.
Is it? Yeah. It was, you met over swords, well, not coffee.
Not many couples can say that they actually met in 71 BC. I tell that to people, they're like, okay.
Yeah, okay. Move a little further away.
So from May, right. More than May, December.
Can you explain?
Yes, so we actually met on the set of Spartacus in New Zealand about 5-6 years ago. Aww. Yep.
Yeah.
And so we bonded over reverse grip double daggers as you, oh, there you go.
Over wow. Swords.
There you go. That is us at a gladiator boot camp.
Wow.
he's got his beard. He was on the show, on the film Logan, so they had him looking all grizzly and everything. But that, he looked much different when I first met him.
Oh, what did he look like when you first met him?
Slightly terrifying.
Oh, good. But you like slightly terrifying.
I think I do. I think right. I'm just like, something there's good. A fear factor and a mystere to the relationship.
Why did it?
So it was love at first sight for you, but not so much for your mother when you took
right,
him home.
Right. So, like I said, we met on the show Spartacus. He yeah. had to have a bald head because they actually glued a mullet to his head. Oh. So I always knew him to be bald. And then from there, he went on to the film Mad Max. And he had to be completely bald for that. And while he was visiting me on location in New Zealand, he chomped on a chicken bone and he broke his tooth in half.
No.
So not only was he bald, but had a chipped tooth.
Wow.
And being
so
a stuntman, he likes to carry around a utility knife, like a Swiss Army knife. I mean, just in case. You know, in case the apocalypse happens, mate, you just need to have, you need to
be prepared.
Yes, so of course my mother, when she first meets him, he's bald, snaggle tooth with a knife, and she's like, he's a thug. I'm like, no, mom, I swear, like, just look into his eyes, he's really sweet.
We could tell he's a nice guy. Well, since that time, his hair has grown back.
Yes.
The tooth fixed.
Yes.
And
yes.
the relationship repaired. Right?
Yes.
And he is here with us. Hey, Stephen, how are you?
Oh, he doesn't look like
look how handsome he is.
Yes.
I don't believe a word you say. That.
You look so nice.
He does. He cleans up well, doesn't he?
I'm not smiling properly because I chipped my tooth.
I mean, you could be a SEAL team member. I mean, look at him. He's got the jawline and the whole bit. How did you feel, Stephen, when mom was not so hip on the whole look?
What do you do? I was out to impress her. I mean, she's my mother-in-law now, so she's mm-hmm. a wonderful lady.
Yeah.
Could you tell that she didn't like you?
Yeah. She's not backward in coming forward about how she feels about me or how she feels about anything, really. So she made it pretty prominent. Pretty
straight
away. But,
doesn't hold back.
I was a thug.
Good. Yes, but now he's become the favorite. He's become the Aww. Favorite. It's like, oh, you yeah. can come visit, honey. So is Stephen's coming, right? Stephen's going to be there, right? I'm like, yeah, he'll be there for Thanksgiving. Don't you worry about that.
Yeah, do you care if I'm coming?
As soon as he leaves, it's like, okay.
But I will say this. There's the softer side of this, Stephen. Of Stephen. Look at these wedding photos. You guys, I mean, beautiful. Look at this gorgeous shot.
Where did you guys get married?
Oh my gosh. So we got married in Temecula at a place called the Condor's Nest Ranch, which is a utopia. It's absolutely beautiful. There is horses and peacocks and a chicken coop that in the morning you could wake up and make fresh eggs. It was absolutely incredible. And we got so lucky with the weather, you guys. It was supposed to be 110 degrees, and it plummeted to a freezing 82. Oh. And there was a soft breeze, so I had like the Beyonce wind fan. Like, so for every photo, my veil is just like sweeping in the background, and it was meant to be. Perfect day. It was an absolute.
I mean, this looks like a Hallmark movie poster.
Yeah.
Well, you know, my father, Hart Hollman, actually took those photos.
Did he really?
He took those photos.
Wonderful. Was that before or after Stephen bit into the cake and chipped each other too?
Yeah. This is after everything.
After everything. Okay, redone. Got it.
And the first dance was the chipmunk theme.
Don't miss the swirl premiere of Sharing Christmas. That was oversharing right there. This Sunday at 8/7 Central.
Oh my God.